What if you could throw on a hood and become a Jedi whenever you wanted to win at competition? Well, I'm about to reveal how to destroy your opponent at these 10 common games, no matter how new you are to them, so that friends and family alike will believe you are using the Jedi mind trick. Amazing! Number 10. Darts. We're gonna get a little geeky by using breakthrough loopholes in the dartboard's design discovered by a Nottingham University professor in 2016. Bring out your rulers. First, you need to visualize the layout of a dartboard. The board has a circle split into 20 equal parts. There is a circle halfway inside the board, treble scoring, and another on the outer rim, which is double scoring. Inaccuracy is punished. For example, aiming for 20 but missing will lead you to score 5 or 1. But there's a way around this, and it involves math. Find out your accuracy by throwing 3 darts at the treble 20. Measure how far they fall from your actual target and get an average. Those who have an accuracy within 5mm should aim for the treble 20. Those who can throw within 25mm should aim for the treble 19. Those who can just about get within 60mm should aim for a large area around the center towards the lower left of the bullseye. Also, always try to finish on a power of 2, as opposed to an odd number, because this gives you more alternatives and reduces the number of shots to end your game. Number 9. Scrabble. The key to winning at Scrabble is to think small. Memorize a selection of 2 to 3 letter words that you can drop without warning, taking advantage of triple words. Remember that pluralizing is not against the rules. However, treat S tiles as special gems, as there are only 4 in the whole game. Aim to score at least 10 points with their utilization in order for it to be of good use. Thirdly, place the 3 common ways words end on the right side of your rack, so that you can easily spot an opportunity. For example, ing, and ed. Do the same for beginnings. For example, re, in, and un on the left side. Lastly, keep your eyes open for hooks, which means single letters that can change a word. For example, host to ghost, lush to flush, and hand to handy. Also, memorize some Q without U words. Q scores highest next to the Z tile, but there are only 4 U tiles. Here are some examples. Qatar, Quenet, Fakir, Kabbalah, and Kabbalah. Number 8. An argument. The games we play. While conflict can be off-putting, it's a part of life, so learning to treat a dispute more like a game with rules can be useful. There are 3 principles to winning. Actually write down all the main arguments. Know your facts. Break them with your opponent's perspective, and break both with what an outsider might think. You will have prepared so deeply that your opponent will not be able to logically counter you on the spot. Secondly, do not be defensive if you want an amicable resolution. As the saying goes, never back a rat into a corner. Create the appearance of considering your opponent's point of view, and they may come around on their own accord. Keep the argument about the specific thing you are arguing about, and do not turn it into an attack on who the person is as a person. This is very important. This lets you keep the argument as a nothing personal dispute over something outside of your opponent. Follow these rules, and your opponent will not only respect you, but love you, even when you beat them, because you do it graciously. Number 7. Jenga. Jenga works by removing blocks that make up a tower, one at a time, and then placing each at the top without the tower falling. In 2011, its creator Leslie Scott gave away the secrets of how to win. In order to perform them, you must forget any Jenga advertisements you've seen on TV. Firstly, forget building a skyscraper. Take your time and go for the easy pull and lay. People don't win Jenga, they lose it. This is what happens when you let yourself be influenced in a game. Secondly, throw strategy out of the window. Yes, you heard me. Instead, play move by move, because the tower shifts by how its weight is distributed over time, and each brick is slightly different in size. You will never be able to replicate any strategy for different games. Thirdly, don't be afraid to manipulate the tower. Remember, Jenga is all about shifting weight distribution. For example, when you place a piece on the top, think about what side you position it, as you can help to make the tower more wobbly for the next player. Number 6. Dodgeball. Dodgeball is a game of numbers. Things are being thrown at you, and you want to reduce the odds of them taking you out. Whenever there is a lot of incoming fire, kneel into a crouched position, holding your ball in front of you so you eliminate even more of your body by having the ball as a shield. Then, once the attack passes, stand and fight. If you're not sure, don't throw. Make sure that you always have a viable target first. Throwing incorrectly can lead to the ball getting caught. Always aim at a single target and have a countdown of 3 in your head before you launch. Never throw individually. Bombard single targets with the help of your teammates. Also, spread your team out. This lets you coordinate an attack from different angles, but keeps you from being easily bombarded as a group. Get as close to the part that divides the two teams, called the dead zone, as you can. This makes it harder for opponents to dodge your throw in time. Aim low, and even if you miss, your ball won't get caught. Remember to throw smart, not hard. Last, never stand behind a teammate. If they dodge, you won't see it coming. Number 5. Monopoly. Monopoly follows the Pareto principle, which says that in any complex game, one person eventually accumulates most of everything, leading to around 20% of people having a lot more than the other 80. Follow these 3 steps, and you can also become Hugh Hefner. God rest his soul. Buy up any property you land on at the beginning. This will give you a baseline from which to build up. Keep your eye out for the railways, which are particularly valuable if you can own at least 3. Less than 3 is useless, but if you have this number, they generate continuous cash flow without you having to spend money, and the chances of your opponent falling on them and owing you money is greater than any other property you can own in the game. Don't worry about hotels. Just build 3 houses on each property as soon as you can. Avoid the 2 utilities, Waterworks and the Electric Company, at all costs. There are only 2 of these, which means the probability of your opponent landing on them is low. The payout is also terrible. The best assets are an orange, light blue, and the red. You are now a tycoon in the making. This is by no means an extensive strategy guide, but perhaps that's for a future video. Number 4. Arm wrestling. In professional arm wrestling competitions, each opponent grips thumb to thumb and keeps their forearms positioned parallel to each other. Shoulders and elbows should be lined up on the center of the table, with a groove which each elbow can rest on. Here are the sneaky subtleties behind destroying your bodybuilder friend. Once you start, lean into the table with your stronger foot forward and your hip up against the table. Then pull your wrist towards yourself. This immediately eliminates the strength of the opponent's forearm. Once you have that locked, lean into it with your full body so that you can use your body and arm strength simultaneously. To give yourself even more of a terrific advantage, lean over the top and try to extend your opponent's forearm from their elbow to get them to open up. This will give you maximum leverage and them a lot less, since they will then have to use their bicep when you are using stronger muscles, your shoulders, and the weight of your body. To extend this advantage, turn your body so that you're in a straight line in the direction that you are trying to go with your arm. Number 3. Laser tag. The key to annihilating everyone is to prepare for war ahead of time. Think Call of Duty. Follow these rules to make your friends or colleagues see you are the top dog when they see your scorecard stats. Wear comfortable shoes. Ladies, put those sandals away and don't even think about the heels. Sneakers are best. Stealth colors always. That includes your shoe wear. Anything light makes you easy to spot. Learn the layout quickly. Some spots give you vantage and others cover. Upper levels are great for sniping. Walk sideways to make yourself less of a target. Go for the kids. Every hit tallies up. When it's time to throw down, shoot non-stop sideways like the Terminator taking down a helicopter. Now you're ready. The end is nigh. Number 2. Rock, paper, scissors. Not only gangs throw signs. People think that rock, paper, scissors is a random game, but you can put the odds heavily in your favor if you use a bit of science. Generally, people try to outguess each other by bluffing. For example, some people recommend that if you just lost a round, throw whatever would have beaten them in the previous round, because some opponents get overconfident and throw the same sign twice in a row. But such guessing games are needless. There is only one rule you need. The odds show that if you choose paper for a best out of 3, your odds of winning are very high. The reason for this is double-fold. Firstly, figures show that in the first round, men go for the sturdy rock more than women. Also, both genders prefer scissors the least, which means if you choose paper, you are the least vulnerable to being beaten. Note, most people will not throw the same figure 3 times in a row, so throw paper 3 times and eat their soul. Number 1. Pool. There are 2 major errors rookie pool players make. Here's how to eliminate them and massively improve your pool playing skills. The first rule is to be aware of your emotions. A shaky hand or overeagerness is the most common way people give away victory. To make this rule more concrete, use more than one or two practice strokes whenever you are not in the flow of things. Ignore the daggers being stared your way by your opponent and take your time until you calm down and find your rhythm. Other ways of delaying are to take a step back, re-chalk your cue stick, or take another swig of that Red Bull. Also, when you break in 9-ball, aim straight at the 1. In 8-ball, aim at the second ball. It ups your chances of sinking the 8 straight away. The second screw-up is perhaps even more common. Maybe you always miss cue, that is, your cue slips rather than hitting the white cue ball straight on. This happens if you hit too high on the cue ball, rather than the center, and so the cue slips. Ever heard the saying, punt through your opponent, not at them? What you're probably doing is stopping just after you hit the white ball, and your cue jerks upwards. Instead, push through in a long line, even if you are putting spin on the ball. As a bonus, you'll find the cue ball moves faster and has greater spin.